Which 8-core laptop CPU is better, AMD's Ryzen 7 5800H or Intel's i7-11800H? Let's find out. These are the differences in specs between these two processors. Both are 8-core, 16-thread parts, but Intel has more cache this generation. The Intel chip has a higher maximum boost clock, but this will depend on things such as power limits and the workload being run. The Intel platform also has newer PCIe Gen 4, so faster storage and bandwidth to the Nvidia graphics. For this comparison, I'm using the XMG Neo 15, the same Tongfeng chassis as the Electronics MEC 15G3. Both laptops have the full-powered Nvidia RTX 3070 graphics inside. Same battery, same 1440p screen, and I've even tested the exact same physical memory sticks in both. So 32GB of DDR4 3200 CL22 dual-rank memory in dual-channel. I've tested both of these laptops with a 45W TDP and a higher 80W TDP, because this is as high as the power limit sliders on the Ryzen model go, though the Intel model does have more headroom at up to 120W. Although TDP may be measured differently depending on the platform, I found that both laptops were drawing a similar amount of power from the wall in Blender, a multi-threaded rendering workload, just a few watts difference at either power limit. These are the clock speed averages over all 8 cores during the same test, so not too much difference. But we can see that at 45 watts, the Ryzen 7 5800H was higher than the i7-11800H. But then Intel takes the lead once both have higher power limits. Here's how fast Blender was actually completing on both laptops. Both laptops were taking the exact same amount of time to complete the longer classroom test with the higher 80W power limit. However, Intel was a few seconds faster in the shorter BMW test. With the lower 45W power limits though, Intel is significantly behind. It's a similar deal in Cinebench R23 for the multi-core score. AMD's Ryzen is significantly ahead when both processors are limited to a lower 45W TDP. But then with the higher 80W limit, Intel's 11800H is able to scrape the win, though it's close. The i7 was always ahead by about 6% when it came to single-core score though. Ryzen 5000 used to beat Intel's 10th gen Comet Lake in the single-core test, but now 11th gen Tiger Lake is back ahead. I've tested Geekbench because it also has both a single-core and multi-core test. Again, the 11th gen 11800H was ahead in single-core, and this is regardless of the power limit, because neither of these power limits should restrict a single-threaded task. Once more, Ryzen was ahead with the 45W limit for multi-core, but then Intel came out ahead with more power. HandBrake was used to convert a 4K H.264 video file that I shot to 1080p H.265. Lower times are better here. Are you seeing a trend yet? Intel's 11800H is slower with the lower power limit, but once it can stretch its legs with the higher limit, it's faster. Adobe Photoshop was tested with the Puget System's benchmark. There's less of a difference here compared to most other tests. And although the difference in performance narrows in with the higher power limit, the Ryzen laptop was still ever so slightly ahead. V-Ray uses the processor to render out a scene. This is a multi-core test, and with the lower power limit, the Ryzen 7 5800H was scoring around 31% higher than the Intel i7-11800H. However, the tables turn again with the higher 80W power limit, with the i7 now 7% ahead. The Corona benchmark is another multi-threaded rendering workload, though a lower score is better this time around, but similar results. AMD much faster with lower power limit, but then Intel coming in ahead with the higher power limit. Linux kernel compilation is a threaded workload, and lower times are better here, so Ryzen was a fair bit faster with the lower 45W power limit, while Intel was then 14% faster with the 80W power limit. And this was the biggest difference between the two processors in favor of Intel out of all applications tested. Microsoft Excel, on the other hand, was one of the few tests that still was better on the Ryzen 7 5800H, even with higher power limits. I believe this test lacks cache, but Intel's 11800H has more total cache available. So now I'm not too sure what the deal is, but it's still a win for AMD. Speaking of AMD win, 7-Zip was used to test compression and decompression. And this is another of the few tests where Ryzen was able to do better even with the higher power limit, well, at least for the decompression test. Intel was still ahead when it came to compression, as per the lighter purple bar. Power limits don't seem to affect AES encryption or decryption, but the Intel system was ahead in both cases. This was one of the few times the 11800H was able to come out ahead of the 5800H with the lower 45W power limit. The only other times were in single-threaded tests. These are the differences when looking at all of the applications just tested with a lower 45W TDP limit in place. In most applications, Intel's i7-11800H is performing worse than AMD's Ryzen 7 5800H. It of course depends on the workload, but basically the 11800H was only doing better in the two single-core workloads and the AES tests at the top, at least with these lower power limits. In CPU-only workloads such as these tasks, laptops are often able to run much higher than 45 watts, though it of course depends on the specific machine. If we instead compare both laptops running with the higher 80W power limit, then Intel is ahead in most of the applications tested. AMD's Ryzen i7-11800H only really still has an edge when it comes to 7-zip decompression, Microsoft Excel, while Adobe Photoshop was within margin of error. I've tested Cinebench R23 multicore at different power limits so we can see how performance scales based on the power limit. The 5800H, shown by the red bars, is outperforming the 11800H, shown by the blue bars, with lower power limits. The gap starts to narrow when both are running with a 60-watt TDP, and then at 70 watts and above, the 11800H is able to take the lead, at least in this test. Not all laptops will allow the processor to run this high in a CPU-only workload though, which is why it's important to check power limits in reviews, as we can clearly see here how this affects results. The Intel platform also has the advantage of further tuning with undervolting, though some laptops may lock this down and not allow it. It's allowed on my laptop, however I found minus 0.1 volts unstable on my machine, and half that wasn't really making a difference here. The change is well within margin of error. This comes down to silicon lottery, so specific results will vary. Both of these laptops also have the same 93 watt hour battery inside, and testing both with the integrated graphics enabled, aka Optimus, we can see that the Ryzen option was lasting longer. Both laptops again have the exact same memory and same 1440p screen, so this should be quite comparable. The Ryzen option was also able to perform better in multi-core tests when running on battery power, though Intel still has the edge in single core. This shouldn't be too unexpected, as battery power means we're running with lower processor power limits, and we've already seen Ryzen does better there. Despite both laptops being the same model and as similar as possible, there are some differences to note. We can see that the CPU and GPU layout differs between the Intel and AMD configurations, resulting in a slight difference in the heat pipes. Unfortunately, I'm not able to fairly compare temperatures here, probably for the same reason that it was skipped over in the recent Linus Tech Tips video where they also had two XMG laptops to compare Intel and AMD. And this is because the Intel model ships with liquid metal, while the Ryzen model has standard thermal paste. For the purposes of this comparison though, I don't believe that's going to be an issue, as thermal throttling was never being hit. So the paste difference on these two machines won't affect the results seen previously, but it does unfortunately mean that I can't fairly compare temperatures. Obviously, we expect the Intel model to come out cooler as it's got that liquid metal. Now, just for the person in the comments saying that I could have removed the liquid metal and applied regular thermal paste, yeah, I suppose that's true. But hey, I've got no personal experience applying liquid metal, and I don't really want to try and remove it on this machine that's not mine. And same deal with the AMD model. Again, I've got no liquid metal experience, and I don't really want to brick XMG's laptop, so I just chose not to do it. Now, perhaps most importantly is the price difference. This will change over time, so refer to those links down in the description for updates. At the time of recording, XMG sells the Core 15 gaming laptop with Ryzen 7 5800H for 1,588 euros, or the Intel i7-11800H model for 41 euros more, or less than 3% extra money. This is the RTX 3060 configuration, so with higher specs like RTX 3070, in terms of a percentage difference, it would be even smaller. So then, what should you get, AMD or Intel? I'd say as long as the laptop is actually able to run the processor up to higher power limits, Intel would be better. As we've seen with more power, it does beat AMD in most of these tests. But the power limit is always going to vary based on the specific laptop, and at lower power limits as we saw, AMD did have the advantage there. Additionally, AMD also had the advantage when it came to battery life and performance on battery. So if you need to run your machine on battery power, then Ryzen could be the better pick. So what about gaming? I'll compare 10 different games on both laptops at 1080p and 1440p resolutions in an upcoming video very soon, as adding those results to this video would make it way too long. So make sure you're subscribed for the upcoming gaming comparison between these two laptops. There's a lot more to discuss, like PCIe differences. Come and join me in Discord and get behind the scenes videos by supporting the channel on Patreon, and come and check out some of my other laptop comparisons over here next. I'll see you over in one of those.